In this tutorial, you will learn how to create a realistic landscape material that will automatically paint textures on the landscape so you can save time when creating environments. We will go from a basic setup to materials with multiple automated layers, but more on that later. If that sounds interesting, let's get right into it. First, let's go over exactly what we want to achieve. That is a material that automatically changes textures, such as albedo and normal, when the angle of the slope between the surface's normal and up vector is too big. So let's take this slope as an example. What we are aiming for is having this part automatically painted for us with a specific texture, for instance rocks, while still supporting manual painting over here. Now let's hop into Unreal and start creating right away. So we are starting things off with a basic landscape material, just so I will be able to show you how painting the landscape will behave. Basically, what I got here are two materials, grass and soil, that I can paint using this layer blend node. So first of all, let's bring in the rock textures. So I'm just gonna go in my content browser, select all of these and drag them in here. Now we can't simply use these textures, we will need to world align them. You will see in just a bit what that means if you've never seen that before. So first let's go to our normal and convert this to a texture object. And let's do the same for the diffuse texture. So for the normal, we simply need to get world align normal. And for the diffuse texture, we need to get world align texture. Then we will have to get vertex normals in world space, which we will multiply with a vector that has one on all the three axes. So let's get a vector 3 and then go to red and put 1, green 1 and blue 1. Then we can just plug this in B, and from here we are going to normalize, so we are only going to keep the direction. Then this is going to be plugged in the world space normals. Now these textures are going to be very small, so we need to bring in a scalar parameter and call this tiling. And because these are so small, this has to be a pretty big number, like 1500. And then we can just plug this in the texture size for both of these. And we can also plug this in UVs. Now, in order to combine everything we just created, we will need a node called make attributes. And if you closely look at this node, you can see just how similar it is to the main material node. Because we are basically creating a material inside a material. So let's go on and plug everything we need in here. And also make sure that you are going to plug the right textures in the right pins. So now let me show you what world align textures do. If I'm going to move this cube, the texture is not going to move with it. Instead, it is going to look like we are scrolling through the texture. And this is very useful for us because this way we can easily avoid texture problems on the landscape. So now, how exactly do we automatically paint this texture on the landscape? For that, first we will need to get the up vector. And to do that, we need to get a constant tree vector with the blue value 1 and the others 0. And keep in mind that red, green and blue actually translate to X, Y and Z. So by doing this, we are basically getting a vector with x0, y0 and z1, which is upwards. Now we will want to transform this vector. And we want to go from tension space to world space. This node here is going to transform the up vector of the tension space to world space. From here, we will want to normalize this because we only care about the direction. And now, between the normalized output and this vector, we are going to do the dot product. So plug in A the normalized output and in B the vector. And we are going to use this dot product to compare the difference in directions. So let's preview this real quick. You can see how on top we have 1 and in the middle we have 0. What is below 0 is not 0, it is actually negative numbers, but we cannot display that. So imagine this, at the top you have 1, in the middle 0 and at the bottom minus 1. That is because when two vectors are perpendicular on each other, the dot product is going to be 0. When the angle between the vectors is 180, then the dot product is going to be negative. But when the angle is between 0 and 90, that dot is going to return a positive value. So what we can do from here is get a linear interpolation and plug this in alpha. And then let's get a scalar parameter and call this height min. And we can copy this and rename this to height max. And this is going to be plugged in B and the first one in A. And let's set the value for the minimum to minus 5 and the value of maximum to 3. If we are going to preview this, we will basically see the same thing. The only difference is that the negative numbers start much earlier. So now we can easily control how big the angle difference has to be until the rocks will start being painted. So if I will change the minimum from minus 3 to minus 1, this is going to be much closer to the middle. But by going back to minus 5, the angle difference threshold is going to be much lower. Now from here we can get a chip contrast. And we can get a scalar parameter called contrast and set the default value to 3 and then plug this in contrast. Now what this is going to control is how sudden the change between grass and rocks is going to be. So now essentially, black is going to represent where rocks are going to appear, while white represents where grass is going to appear. You can quite literally think of it as slapping grass on rocks. Now the final step is going to be getting a layer blend standard. This is going to allow us to blend between these make material attributes and the layer blend. So plug result in alpha, then in the base material plug the make material attributes for the rocks, and then for the top material plug in the layer blend. Now the actual last step is to break the material attributes, which is the reverse function of making material attributes. And now we just have to plug in all of these. And now after applying everything, we can see how this looks in the preview. After tweaking some of the parameters we set up, this is how the material looks on a landscape. While this is good, we are not yet done. There are two things we can still improve on. A more realistic blend between the materials, as well as a secondary material for smoother slopes. So let's see how that is done. Firstly, we need to bring in a new set of textures and apply the same process of word aligning and combining them into a material. Now that we did that, what we can also do is copy this part right here because we are going to reuse 95% of it. So to remind you, what we are getting right now is a black sphere with a white top. But instead of this, let's do the following. Let's go to our up vector and from here get a linear interpolation. Then in the alpha plug 0.1. And then in B, we should plug our normal. And now you can see just how much different this looks. Instead of having that smooth transition like a gradient, we are going to get this based on the normal. Now this might be just a bit too much, so we can go to height maximum and set this to 3. And this is the way we are going to transition between grass to smaller rocks and to our big rocks. Obviously, you can also use the normal for the big rocks, but I decided not to. But if you decide to do that, just apply the same process using the linear interpolation and the normal. Now, in order to combine our three layers, we have to go and cut this standard blend from here. Now, instead of firstly combining the bigger rocks with the grass, we have to combine the grass with the smaller rocks. So for that, let's go to the layer blend and right here paste the material layer blend standard, then plug in the top material the layer blend. Then for the base material, go to your smaller rocks, go to the make material attributes node and plug that in here. And for the alpha, it is the same thing. We have to plug in here this chip contrast. So now if we are going to preview this, we will still see that blend between the grass and the rocks, but it is going to be much more natural. Now what we need to do is to combine this with the big rocks. So let's copy the node and paste it again. Then in the alpha, plug the chip contrast. Then in the top material, we will plug the result from our previous blend. And then in the base material, we will plug the make attributes from the big rocks. And now all of this is going to go into the break material attributes. Now you might notice that there is no difference between this and the previous material. That is because we need to change these parameters right here and give them different names. So I'm going to call this height minimum 1, and then I will call this height maximum 1. As well, let's also change the contrast from contrast to contrast 1. Before playing around with the material instance and its parameters, let me explain exactly what is happening. First of all, imagine that we have a sphere with a grass material. Now, we are going to keep the light area as it is and change everything that is dark to rocks. In the end, getting to something like this. Now, imagine that we have a sphere with this result. We are going to keep everything that is in the light area as it is and change everything in the dark area with even bigger rocks. Getting to a result where we are going to have grass at the top, small rocks in the middle, and big rocks at the bottom. So now let's apply everything and play around with the parameters we set up. So let's say that we want to have more smaller rocks. What we can do is go to height max and then increase it. And as you can see, now the small rocks are even more visible. Now let's say that we want to have more grass. What we can do is go to height minimum 1 and increase it. And as you can see, now we are going to have even more grass. Besides the awful landscape, I would say that this looks pretty good. Especially now that we have normal blending for gentle slopes, as well as a second set of textures to help with the transition between grass and rocks. And all of this can be adjusted from these parameters. If you want to stay up to date with other tutorials like this one, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell so you won't miss anything. As well, consider supporting my work over on Patreon like these kind folks. AviramaFM, Badela Kaktani, Giovanni Pena, Golden Glow Master, Leonardo Pereira, Luke Chargers, Realitas Verlust, and Tamon Gehring. Let me know in the comments, do you prefer automated or manual materials? Personally, I think a mix of both is the right way to go, and I can't wait to hear your answers. Now make sure to watch this tutorial to learn more about procedural stuff for environments. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.